We are happy to join you today in what will go down in history as the greatest demonstration of nouns in the history of grammar.
Let us start out with the basics for our kind ladies and gentlemen. A noun is a word used to name a person, animal, place, thing, or an abstract idea. Whatever exists can be named. And that name is a noun.
Wonderfully said. Now let us get into some more detail as to how we can classify nouns. Nouns have different classes: concrete and abstract, proper and common, count and non-count, and collective. Let us start by looking at concrete nouns. Concrete nouns are something physical. You can experience concrete nouns with your five senses. You see, hear, smell, taste, and feel them.
Martin, let us try that out with a sentence so we can show our audience exactly what we mean. A nation's culture resides in the hearts and in the soul of its people. In this sentence we have many nouns: nation, culture, hearts, soul and people. The concrete nouns, nation, culture, and people are colored red.
Yes, Mohandas. That's it. The other nouns in the sentence fall into the other class known as abstract nouns. You cannot experience an abstract noun with your senses. It states an idea or a concept. Abstract nouns usually represent feeling, ideas and qualities. Let's look at that sentence again, to find the abstract nouns. A nation's culture resides in the hearts and in the soul of its people. Let's point out the abstract nouns. They are colored orange. Hearts and soul.
Wait. I think this may be confusing to our viewers. Let us clarify. Hearts could be either a concrete or an abstract noun. You have to look at the way the word is actually used in order to make the distinction. In my sentence, hearts means the people's emotional constitution or basic disposition. So, heart is definitely not concrete in this case. Surely, it is abstract, and of course, so is the word soul. However, if I had said, the surgeon must operate on his heart, heart would have been classified as a concrete noun.
Exactly. Here is one more example. At the center of nonviolence stands the principle of love. The nouns in the sentence are center, nonviolence, principle, and love. Amazing! All the nouns are abstract.
Yes, indeed they are. We both have most often dealt with abstract nouns in our lives.
Every noun can further be classified as common or proper. Proper nouns name specific, one-of-a-kind items, while common nouns identify the general varieties. A proper noun has two distinctive characteristics. 1. It will name a specific, usually a one-of-a-kind, item. And 2. It will begin with a capital letter no matter where it occurs in a sentence. Some examples of proper nouns are the Taj Mahal, Burger King and Albert Einstein, since only one of each exist.
Recognize a common noun when you see one. Common nouns are general names for things. Some examples include book, bus, cookie, mess, and clothes. Common nouns are never capitalized unless they begin a sentence or are part of a title. Here is a sample sentence where we can identify proper and common nouns. The people of Europe learned their lessons from the writings of the men of Greece or Rome, which exist no longer in their former glory. We have 8 nouns in this sentence. The yellow ones are proper, and the chartreuse are common.
Yes, of course. There is only one. Europe, Greece and Rome. But there can be many, people, lessons, writings, men, and glories.
Smashing Martin. Well said. We have yet another classification of nouns. Count and non-count. Many nouns can be singular or plural, these are count nouns. Non-count nouns, on the other hand, have only a singular form. Here is a tip. If you can add a number to the front of a noun and put an S at the end of it, you have a count noun. Some nouns, however, have only a singular form. These are non-count nouns.
Here are some examples. Hurricane, chair, smile, bagel, book, and assignment are all count nouns. You can add an S to the end of each word and get the plural form. Non-count noun examples are weather, furniture, happiness, flower, information, and homework. Here is a tip to help you remember. Concrete nouns can be countable. And some proper nouns are countable.
Now, let us look at this sentence for examples of countable and non-countable nouns. The cry for peace will be a cry in the wilderness, so long as the spirit of non-violence does not dominate millions of men and women.
Brilliant example. The countable nouns are colored green, and the non-countable nouns are azure. Finally, we come to collective nouns. This is a special class that names groups composed of members, usually, but not always people. Some examples of collective nouns are army, audience, class, family, group, jury, majority, public, school, society, and team. In the sentence, the minority protested in front of the White House. Minority is a collective noun because it refers to a group of people.
Magnificent. I believe that concludes our great demonstration on nouns. Now, let us go back and review the classifications. Nouns are words used to name a person, place, thing or idea. Nouns can be classified as such. Concrete nouns can be experienced with your five senses. Abstract nouns usually represent feeling, ideas and qualities. Proper nouns name specific, one-of-a-kind items, while common nouns identify the general varieties. Nouns that can be singular or plural count nouns. Non-count nouns, on the other hand, have only a singular form. Collective nouns name groups.
That was our great demonstration on nouns. I have a dream today. I have a dream that each and every one of you will have learned all about nouns and the different ways to classify them. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you. And goodbye.